여, 안녕하십니까?
Hello everyone.
성경 말씀 읽겠습니다.
Let's open up our Bible.
10장입니다.
Hebrews chapter 10.
1절부터 읽겠습니다.
Read from verse 1.
우리 10장을 찾으시기 바랍니다.
Please open your Bible to Hebrews chapter 10.
율법은 장차오는 좋은 일의 그림자의 참 형상이 아니므로 마다 늘 드린 바와 같은 제사로 나오는 자들 언제든지 온전케 할 수 없느니라.
For the law having a shadow of good things to come and not the very image of the things can never with those sacrifices which they offered year by year continually make the comers thereunto perfect.
그렇지 않으면 섬기는 자들 단번에 정결케 되어 다시 죄를 깨닫는 일이 없으리니 어찌 드리는 일을 그치지 아니하였으리요.
For then would they not have ceased to be offered because that the worshippers once purged should have had no more conscience of sins.
그러나 이 제사들은 해마다 죄를 생각하게 하는 것이 있나니?
But in those sacrifices there is a remembrance again made of sins every year.
이는 황소와 염소의 피가 능히 죄를 없이하지 못함이라.
For it is not possible that the blood of bulls and of goats should take away sins.
그러므로 세상이 마실 때 가라사대 하나님 제사와 예물을 원치 아니하시 오직 나를 위한 몸을 예비하셨도다.
Wherefore when he cometh into the world, he saith, sacrifice and offering thou wouldest not, but a body hast thou prepared me.
전제로 범죄와 속죄 기뻐하지 아니하시나니.
In burnt offerings and sacrifice, for since thou hast no pleasure.
이에 내가 말하기를 하나님 보시옵소서 두루마리 치게 나를 가리키려 한 것 같이 하나님 뜻을 행하러 왔나이다.
Then I said, I come in the volume of the book it is written of me to do thy will, O God.
이에 말씀하 제사와 예물과 전제로 범죄와 속죄 원치도 아니 기뻐하지도 아니하신다 하셨고 이는 다 율법을 따라지는 것이다.
Above when he said sacrifice and offering and burnt offerings and offerings for sin thou wouldest not, neither hast a pleasure therein which are offered by the law.
그 후에 말씀에 보시옵소서 내가 하나님 뜻을 행하러 왔나이다 하셨으니 그 첫 것을 폐하시면 둘째 것을 세우려 하십니다.
Then said he, Lo, I come to do thy will, O God. He taketh away the first, that he may establish the second.
이 뜻을 쫓아 예수의 몸을 단번에 드리심으로만 우리가 거룩함을 얻었노라.
By the which will we are sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all.
네, 거기까지 읽었습니다.
We read up to verse 10.
우리 히브리서를 읽어보면
As we read the book of Hebrews
사실 성경이 하도 어렵지 않고 자세히 이해가 잘 되는 이야기들인데
Actually, Bible is not that difficult. We could all understand that.
대부분의 사람들 자기 관념으로, 자기 개념으로 히브리서를 읽어보면
But most people, when they try to read the Bible with their own concept
그게 이제 성경하고 잘 안 맞는 거예요.
Does not fit and go well with the Bible.
왜 성경은 예수 떠 있다니 우리 죄가 사해지는 게 원칙인데
Because according to the Bible, the principle is that our sins are washed through Jesus.
기독교가 타락해지면서
But as the Christianity when corrupted
종교 지도자들 교회 성도를 어떻게 잘 다스릴까 하는
many,
그런 계획들을 세우고 있는 겁니다.
Many religious leaders are thinking of how they could lead their people well.
제가 이제 교회 안에 사역을 하면서
As I do my ministry in the church
종종 목회자들 가운데 어떤 사람들 가운데 이런 사람이 있어요.
Once in a while I come across pastors and leaders who are like this.
아, 나는 참 난 영적인 사람인데.
Well, I'm a very spiritual person.
나는 구원받아서 많이 일어나는데.
And many people that are being saved through me.
그런 마음을 가진 사람들은
Those who hold on to this kind of a heart
아주 순식간에 타락을 해버려.
In an instance they can go corrupted.
자기를 믿는 마음이 빠르게 일어나는 거예요.
They would have this strong confidence in themselves.
그래서 하나님은 제가 신앙생활하면 다른 사람보다 좋았던 게 뭐가 있었냐면
But what I found better in my spiritual life
전 다른 사람보다 잘하는 게 아무것도 없었어요.
I'm not good at anything compared to anyone else.
내가 하나에서 열을 보면 열, 백을 봐, 백을 봐도 내가 남들보다 잘한다는 게 뭐 있나.
From 10 out of 10, 100 of 100, I'm not better than in anything than anyone else.
1962년도에 구원을 받고 난 뒤에
Once I got saved in 1962,
복음에 살고 싶었지만
I wanted to live for the gospel.
저희 누님이 저를 보고 말리셨어요.
But my older sister told me not to.
옥수야, 너는 절대 목회자 된다고 생각지 마라.
My sister said, "옥수, do not think
예,
of becoming a pastor."
그렇게 생각 안
해. I never thought of it myself either.
그 저희들 시골 교회에서 종종 이제 수양의 그저 뭐야 대전도 집회 사경회 같은 걸 하면은
Once in a while when we had a revival in our village church
김천이나 대구에서 목사님 초대하다가 우리가 말씀을 들어요.
We would invite pastors from Gimcheon and from big cities and we would hear the word from him.
너무 멋있어 보이고 훌륭해 보이고 우리는 너무 초라하게 보여 늘 그랬어.
In our eyes, they seemed so great and wonderful. In our eyes, we seemed so miserable and pitiful.
난 한 번도 내가 목사가 된다고 생각해 본 적이
Never once I thought of becoming a pastor in my life.
근데 정말 제가 하나님 언제 처음 63년도 성교학교를 갔고
By the grace of God, I went to the missionary school in 1963.
성교학교 내가 나오고 난 뒤에 내가 목회자 된다 상상도 하지 않았어요.
When I got discharged from the missionary school, I never thought of becoming a pastor.
성교 마친 뒤에 딴 사람 오라는데 전 오라는 사람 아무도 없었어요.
Everyone else was dispatched, but me.
그냥 고향에 다시 돌아가기 싫어서.
I just didn't want to go to my village.
없으니까.
I had nowhere else to go.
그 창에 우리가 그 집회가 또 오면서 압곡도 한번 들린 경험이 있는데.
Once we had stopped by 거창 압곡동 when after the conference, so I just decided to go into 압곡동.
그래서 9개월 동안 있는 동안에.
During my stay there for 9 months.
저는 진짜 살아계신 하나님을 많이 경험했어요.
I could experience God who was alive.
우리가 정상적으로 생각하면 그 9개월이면 저는 굶어 죽어야 했고.
You know, I could have died for those 9 months.
국민들에게 제가 도움을 받은 게 거의 없어요.
I was barely helped by the people who were living in the village.
감자 몇 개뿐이었을 거예요.
Maybe just I got just you know a couple of you know potatoes.
근데 그 9개월 동안 사는 동안에.
But during my stay there for 9 months.
하나님의 은혜로 내가 그 9개월 삼 아무의 손을 벌리지 아니하고 내가 어려움을 이야기하지 않고. 시간마다 물론 굶을 때도 있지만
I never stretched out my hand to anyone to help me and never I begged for food.
한 번은 어떤 형제가 지나가던 압곡동을 찾아왔어요.
Once there was a brother who was passing by, stopped by 압곡동 and to come to see me.
근데 우리 사는 거 돈을 좀 주고 갔는데
And he saw the way I was living and he gave me some money. It was a little money that he gave me.
그래서 제가 게 쌀을 한 대를 사면은
And if I just buy a you know little bit of rice with that
며칠 뭐 못 먹죠.
I can just last few days with it.
보리쌀을 사면 쌀보다 한 배를 더 먹게 돼.
But if I buy barley instead of rice, I can buy the double the portion.
근데 밀을 사면은 또 보리쌀 배.
But if I buy the flour, I can buy the 4 times more than the rice.
쌀 한 대 값을 가진 밀을 사면은
The money for one, you know, one little bit of rice, one sack of little rice.
먹을 수 있는 양식이 되는.
You know, I can buy the wheat and I can, you know, last about a month with
하여튼
it.
그런 삶을 살면서
So as I lived that kind of a life,
한 번도 사람들께 내가 없는 걸 알리지 아니하고
I never, you know, sent any signal to anyone that I'm running out of your food.
의지하고 살았는데,
so I just relied on God.
지금도 그때 삶이 너무 신기하고 좋은 거예요.
But even now, when I look back my life, that life was very amazing and wonderful.
내가 마지막에 압곡동에 있다 이제 다시 그 본부에서 그 창원가로 떠날 때에.
I was in 압곡동 and from the headquarters, they sent me to 거창.
내가 무슨 생각하느냐면은.
I thought of this.
내가 굶어 죽지 않았다.
Oh, I've not starved to death.
내가 반대로 굶어 죽었는지 모른다는 그런 가능성이 있어 보이는데.
You know, there was a possibility that I could have starved to death.
진짜 그런 가능성, 내가 굶어 죽을 마음이 있어서 뭐 그게 못 잊고 도망갔을 것 같아.
If I had thought so, I wouldn't have stayed there until the end.
한 번도 그런 생각 해본 적이.
But never once I had thought so.
근데 너무너무 신기한 때때로 하나님이 저를 먹이신 거예요.
But the amazing thing was God fed me from time to time.
복음을 전하기 위해서 시장을 가는데
So I went to the market to preach the gospel.
산길을 선택해 갔어요.
So I went to the mountain road.
죄송합니다. 산에서 이제 약간 용면 보려고 하는데
So I went out of the road and I went out to urinate somewhere.
조금 밑에 내려왔는데
So I went lower place from the mountain road.
이 딸기가 농사 지은 것처럼 많이 달렸어요.
There I saw these wild strawberries as if someone had cultivated it.
이거 하나 바로 길에서 좀 밑에 떨어진 곳인데.
You know, it was not too far from the mountain road.
길에서 한번 내려 그 딸기가 보이더라고.
It was not visible from the road, but when I got down from the road, I could see that.
이게 딸기 따먹는 거 다 따먹고 가서 보니까.
And I ate all those wild strawberries when I went to the market.
끝났더라고.
The market had closed already.
하여튼 너무너무 저희들이 감사했어요.
So I was very thankful anyway.
정말 많이 굶기도 그랬는데.
It's true, we used to starve.
내 마음에 하나님이 나를 이끌어가는 그게 너무 놀라웠어요.
But I could vividly see how God was leading me.
저는 한 번도 뭘 잘한다고 생각해 본 적이 없어요.
I never thought that I was good at anything before.
제가 하는 모든 걸 잘한 게 아무것도 없었어요.
Because in everything that I was doing, I was not good at it.
그러면 하나님 내 마음을 겸비하게 하시면서.
But as God made my heart to be humble.
하나님만을 의지하고 나갈 때 하나님 어떻게 나를 도우시 정확하게 알 수 있어요.
When I relied on Him, I could precisely see how He could help me.
장팔리 처음에 갔을 때.
When I first went to 장팔리,
제가 그렇게 재밌고 좋을 수가 없어요.
It was so much fun. It was so good.
제일 처음에 심재열 형제 김종용 형제가 구원을 받았어요.
But 심재열 and 김종용 they got saved in the beginning.
그리고 난 뒤에 하나님 저에게 많은 은혜를 베푸셔서.
And since then, God gave me a lot of grace.
정말 저를 도우시 역사에게 너무 하나님 앞에. 감사하고 감사해.
And I could see him helping me and working out for me, and I was so thankful about it.
얼마나 제가 놀라운지 말로 다 할 수 없나.
I was so amazed I could not describe that in words.
그리고 제가 군대에 갔는데.
And later I went to the army.
전부 똑같은 나이죠.
You know, people got to the army, they were pretty much of the same age.
근데 제가 군대 가서 이제 살면서
But as I lived in the military base,
우리 내부안의 삶과 저하고는 진짜 다른 걸 느꼈어요.
The life between life between my life and other people's life, it was not comparable in the barrack.
군대 갈 때 530을 가져왔어.
You know, when I went to the army, I went to you know 530 cents with me.
이제 그 제 그 수첩 명 작은 성경 뒷장에다 그 접어 넣고 풀로 봉했어.
You know, I had one 501 bills. I put it in my pocket and I glued it to the my pockets.
내 옆에 동료가 작업 버리고 고민하길래 그 500원 떼주고 꺼내주고 그 처리하라 그랬어.
And there was one of my comrades who lost his working uniform. I took out that money and gave it to him so he could buy a uniform.
목포장 생긴 한 개 70원 하는데 100원짜리 주고 30원 받아 그거 가지고 군대 갔어.
And later I made my wooden stamp and to that I had to pay you know 70 cents so with the rest with the change the 30 cent I went to the army.
하나님 저를 도우시는 게 너무 감사해.
From then on I could vividly see God were helping me and I was so thankful. I had to go to the army. I was in you know the mission center in Daegu.
군대 갈 시간이 가까운데 기도회를 했는데.
The day was closed and we had to go we had prayer time. But the prayer was not ending.
제가 그 군대 가면서 인사 안 하고 갈 수 없다 끝나고 하니까.
So I could not just go to the base without greeting them. And once the pyramid meeting was over, I went there 1 hour later than others.
전부 다 집합하고 있었어.
So everyone had gathered there already.
내가 늦었다 하니 우리 선교사님이 차를 태워서 군 부대까지 들어왔어.
Because I was late, our missionary he gave me a ride. He brought me all the way to the military base.
외국인 차니까 그냥 통과시켜줘. 그 안에 내가 차에 내린 거 전 부대원이 봤어.
We couldn't drive past the entrance, but because he was missionary, he let him in, so everybody could see that I there in the car.
그 군 한 번 저를 부르더라고.
That evening, one soldier called me.
너 오늘 자가용 타고 왔지.
You are the one who came in a car today, right?
예.
Yes, I am.
부잣집 아들로 왔던 것 같아.
Maybe he took me for an old, maybe rich man's, you know, son.
그래서 저를 보고 내가 너 후방 보내주기로 했다.
He said, I decided to send you to the rear base.
아 감사합니다.
Oh, thank you.
그 막 전방에 고생스러운 이야기 후방 보내주겠다.
If you go to the front page, it's gonna be tougher. It's gonna be hard for you.
그러면 저를 보고 돈을 요구를 하는 거예요.
But he required me some money.
돈 만 원만 내라.
So just pay me $10 and I'll send to the rear unit.
돈 만 원이 없지요.
I had no $10 with me.
없다 그랬어.
I said I have no.
좀 7천 원이 됐어.
He said maybe $7 then.
좀 이따 3천 원.
Later it became $3.
없다 그랬어.
I said I didn't have $3 with me.
너 얼마 있냐 물었어.
How much do you have anyway then?
모르겠습니다. 한 30원 있어요.
And I said maybe 30 cents, I guess.
군대에 돈 30원 가지고 돈 아무도 없을 거예요.
There was no one who would come to the army base with 30 cents but me.
저는 군대 오기 전에 그때 군대 간 어른들 인사 돈을 많이 많은 돈이 모였는데.
Before coming to the base, I greeted you know the age people around me and they gave me this much money.
'Cause
back then the Bible was very precious.
장팔이 성경을 안 가진 사람이 많이 있었어요.
There was not anybody who had Bible in our Changpali church.
성경을 사가지고 우편으로 형제자매들 다 보냈어요.
So I bought those you know Bibles and I sent them by mail to our brothers and sisters in Changpali church.
30원 그거 가져갔는데.
And I was left with 30 cents with me.
돈 얼마냐 묻더라고.
And he asked me how much money do you have?
잘 기억이 안 나. 한 30원 있을 것
같아. I said I don't remember, but maybe 30 cents.
이 사람이 농담한 줄 알았어.
He thought I was joking.
군대 30원 가져온 사람 아무도.
Who would ever come to the base with 30 cents?
안 맞는 거 알아.
So he thought I was joking. I was making fun of him maybe.
아무렇지 않았어.
So I didn't it was not anything wrong with me.
하나님이 내 안에 살아서 일하는데.
But from then on God lived and he worked inside of me.
너무너무 감사.
And I was so thankful.
통신 훈련소에 갔는데
in the communication center base.
아, 일본 사람 군종 참모부에서 군종 행정 실장이 저를 보고 아, 박상병 그때만 저를 조금만 기다려.
From the first army base from the religious department, the lieutenant said, you know, I'll send you one pastor. Military pastor, we're running out of the military chaplain, okay?
교육부대도 군목이 필요한데.
We also need, you know, the chaplain for the training center.
그래 가지고 제가 그 이제 군종병 노릇을 했는데.
So I worked as a religious soldier there.
제가 거기서 매주 토요일마다 후배 오는 사람들 다 잡아놓고 복음 전 그렇게 행복해.
So every Saturday I would gather those, you know, newly came soldiers, and I'll lead the Sunday worship.
그러면서 그 다음에 그 교육 장교가 제가 그렇게 하는 걸 보고 감동을 받아가지고.
When the education officer saw me doing that, he was moved.
저 딴 부대 가는 걸 그 부대에 이제 맞추고 일하도록 해주어서.
He kept me in that base instead of sending me to anywhere else.
3년 동안 그렇게 내가 거기서 복음을 전하게 해주시더라고.
So for 3 years, I could preach the gospel in that base.
내가 군대 제대하고 나오는 날 통신훈련소 정문을 나올 때.
So the day I got the shirt from the army base as I came out of the entrance.
하나님 같이 계시면.
If this God is with me.
살아서면 얼마든지 살겠다.
I'll be able to live in the Sahara Desert.
남극에서 얼마든지 혼자 살겠다.
Even the South Pole, I'll be able to, you know, live there.
제가 맨주먹이었는데.
So I was barehanded.
김천 가기로 마음을 먹었어.
But I decided to go to 김천.
하나님이 다 인도 집을 주면 인도하는 걸.
And I could see God leading me and giving me a house.
아무도 나를 도와줄 사람이 없는데.
No one was there to help me.
굶어 죽지 않고 김천에 살았다는 그 자체도 너무 놀라운 거예요.
The fact that I didn't starve to death but I survived the there, that was amazing. So when I think about it,
하나님 이것보다 좋은 게 없는데.
There's nothing as better, nothing as good as relying on God.
사람들은 자기 가진 거 뭐 실력이나 월급이나 재산 거기에 이제 마음을 두면.
People there lay their hand on their skills and their capacity.
사람 마음이 굉장히 좁아지더라고.
And their heart would be very narrow.
하나님을 믿는 믿음으로 살면,
but if they live with the faith that they have in God,
인생이라도,
faith, living the same life,
하나님 못 믿어 그렇지.
It's because they don't believe God.
만일 우리가 하나님을 믿는다면,
if we do,
천 가지 만 가지 하나님 하지 못한 아무것도 없습니다.
In tens of thousands of things, God will be able to do anything for us.
확실하게 믿음을 가지고 일했을 때,
so when we work with this clear faith,
하나님 저를 도우시는 걸 너무 너무 정확해.
We can precisely see God helping us.
자 이제 하나님이 우리를 위해서 뭘 했냐?
Now what did God do for us?
성경에 하나님 우리를 위해서 죄에서 구원한 이 놀라운 일을 하게 하셨어.
So in order to save us from our sins, God did this wonderful work.
근데 이제 우리를 죄에서 구원받는 이 일을 가르치기 위해서.
So in order to teach us how He washed our sins and saved us from our sins.
십계명 율법을 주시고 할 때 그 부속법 제사법이란 걸 줬어.
When He gave us Ten Commandments, He gave us other laws concerning the offerings and sacrifices. So when you give the sin offering.
저는 제가 그 속죄 제사에 대해서.
Regarding suffering, I read Leviticus chapter 4.
속죄 제사에서 나온 레위기 4장 전체가 속죄 제사에 관한.
The whole chapter of Leviticus 4 it talks about the sin offering.
제일 처음에 제사장이 범죄에서 어떻게 제사를 드리고.
It talks about four categories of you know giving offering when.
온 회중이 범죄 어떻게 제사.
When the leader of the people commits sin, when the congregation commits sin.
속장들이 죄를 범해 어떻게 제.
When the priest commits sin.
나머지 평민이 죄를 어떻게.
When one of the common people commits sin.
이 네 가지 속죄 제사가 있는데.
There are four ways of giving the sin offering.
이제 이 이야기를 자세히 읽으면 하나님의 마음이. 그대로 나타나 보이는.
So when you read this precisely, you can see the heart of God well.
이제 그 속죄 제사로 하는 것은.
So when you know the sin offering.
실제로 예수님이 오셔서 어린 양으로 우리 죄를 위해 죽으실 그것을 그림으로 보여주는 그림이에요.
You know, it depicts Jesus who came as a Lamb of God and who died for our sins.
저는 이 속죄 제사에 관한 글을 읽으면서.
So as I read this chapter concerning the sin offering.
속죄 제사 이제 네 가지 아까도 얘기했지만 제사장이 범죄했을 때.
There are four ways of giving the sin offering, like the when the priest commits sin, when the congregation of Israel commits sin, when the leader of the people commits sin, when a common people commits sin.
네 가지로
So there are four types of you know sin offering.
저는 그때 아무것도 안 평민이니까.
Back then I was an ordinary man.
제사법
선택 제가 I read a part concerning the sin offering for the common people.
4장 27절부터 평민의 제사에 관한 이야기 나오는데.
From Leviticus 4 verse 27 he talks about the sin offering for the common people.
다 거의 다 외웠어.
And I could you know I know it almost by heart.
만일의 평민의 하나가 여호와의 금령 중 하나 부중에 범해 허물이 있다.
If any of the common people sin against the laws or commandment of the Lord and be found guilty,
그 범한 죄의 깨우침을 받거든.
And come to have the knowledge of the sin that he committed,
그는 흠 없는 암염소를 끌고 와서.
He shall then bring the female goat without blemish.
그 그것을 예물로 삼.
And shall take it as the sin offering for his sin.
자 이제 죄의 싹은 사망이니까.
And as the wages of sin is death,
제물이 양이나 염소나 소가 대신 죽어줘야 죄가 씻어진 건 사실.
Goat or the bull, or the lamb has to die for their sin.
근데 이제 그 이 성경 이거 내려가다가.
But as you read down through the chapter,
이제 그 제사장 그 속죄제 희생의 머리에 안수하고 하는 부분.
It says laying your hands on the head of the live goat, the victim.
그 이야기 앞에 제가 잠깐 멈춰진 거예요.
When I read that particular part, I stopped right there.
그다음 제가 알기로는 목사 될 때 안수 받고.
Because we do the laying of hands, we do the ordaining. When you ordain a pastor or an elder.
암염소가 암양이 뭐 그 짐승이 왜 목사 되냐 장로들 안수를 받는.
You know, we are not ordaining the goat as a pastor or as an elder. Why do we do the laying of hands?
근데 성경이란 게 너무 재밌는.
But the Bible is so interesting because
우리가 시에 많은 부서지 그 하나 쓸모없는 다 필요한 것처럼.
You know, watch. We have many different parts, and not one of them is useless.
성경 나온 이야기 하나 하나가 전부 다 연결됐을 때.
And each element in the Bible, when they're related one another, they show us the wonderful will of God. When any of the common people sinned against the commandment of the Lord and found guilt in his sight, you should then bring a female goat without blemish and lay his hands on the head of the goat.
양이나 염소 머리 안수하는 이 부분이 저는 도저히 이해가 안 가는.
I could never understand why we had to do the laying of hands on the head of the lamb or head of the goat.
제가 성경을 보는 게 아니라 안수라는 건 목사 될 때 안수 받고 장로 될 때 안수 받는 걸 봐서.
Because back then, according to what I know, we do the laying of hands for when you ordain a pastor or ordain an elder.
왜 양이나 염소를 안수해야 돼?
Why do you have to do the laying of hands for the goats?
뭐 지가 뭐. 뭔데 목사 되는 것도 장로들 안수해야 돼. 이해가 안 가.
We are not ordaining as an elder or as a pastor. Why do we do the laying of hands?
그때 속죄는 다 여기 딱 막혀. 왜 안수를 해야 하나?
And this is where I got stuck and I could not understand why do we have to do the laying of hands.
그걸 막 성경 아무리 찾아도.
So no matter how much I read through the Bible to figure it out, I could not understand why.
성경 너무너무 재밌는 것이.
But the Bible is so interesting because
어떤 의문
But no questions.
성경 안에 다 푸는 방법이.
There is no question that cannot be answered in the Bible.
성경을 찾아 읽어 어떤 구절 딱 나왔을 때 그게 풀려지는.
So when you get stuck in the Bible, there are other verses that may explain those verses.
우리가 레위기 4장 27절 28절은 제사장이 속죄제 희생 머리 안수한다는 얘기 나오는.
So Leviticus 4:27 it talks about you know the priest laying his hands on the head of the goat and lamb.
4장.
Chapter 4.
5장,
chapter 5.
6장,
6.
7장,
7.
8장.
8.
9장,
9,
10장,
10, 11,
12, 13, 14, 15, 16장. 4장에 16장 몇 차이죠?
You know, what is the difference between 4 and 16?
12절 차이.
So 12 chapters, right?
맞아요.
Right?
근데 여러분 그 12절 차이, 그 12장, 12장 차이인데
So within that 12 chapters,
그 뭐 잠시 읽어만 되는 거예요.
You can just read it briefly. You can figure it out then.
어디에 여러 번 읽었어요.
And I read it many times afterwards.
근데 그게 생각이 안 들어.
But I could not understand it until then.
오늘 성경 읽다가.
One day I was reading the Bible.
16장 21절을 읽는 거.
And I came to read Leviticus 16 verse 21.
깜짝 놀랐어.
I was stunned.
속죄 제사에서 왜 속죄제 희생 머리 안수하는지 그 이유는
I could understand and it talked about the reason why they do the laying of hands for the sin offering.
아론은 두 손으로 산 염소의 머리 안수하여 이스라엘 자손의 모든 불의 그 범한 죄를 구하고 그 죄를 염소의 머리에 두어
And Aaron shall lay both his hands upon the head of the live goat and confess over him all the iniquities of the children of Israel all their transgressions and all their sins putting them upon the head of the goat.
그러니까 이제 속죄 제사에서
So in the sin offering
그 양이나 염소나 송아지 머리 안수하는 것은
With the laying of hands for, on the head of the goat and lamb
내가 가지는 이 죄를 양에게 넘기는 그 예식인 거예요.
It was to transfer and to put your sins on the head of the goat and lamb.
16장 1절에서
So Leviticus 16 verse 21
두 손으로 산 염소 머리 안수하 이스라엘 자손의 모든 불의와 그 범한 죄를 구하고
And Aaron shall lay both his hands upon the head of the goat live goat and confess over him all iniquities of children of Israel
그 핵심이 그 죄를 염소의 머리에 두어
And the core part is putting the sins upon the head of the goat
그러니까 양이나 염소를 잡아 속죄 제사를 드릴 때에
So when they kill the lamb or the goat as a sin offering
그냥 그 죽으면 안 되고
They shouldn't just kill it
양이나 염소 죄 없는 어린 양인데 거기다 안수해서 우리 죄를 거기다 넘긴 뒤에
The lamb and goat they're innocent but after having put your sin upon the head of the goat and lamb
우리 죄가 양이 건너가 양이 죽는 죽으면 바로 그 죄를 사는 죽음이 되는 거예요.
Once the sin is transferred, the goat that the goat dies it is a sin, goat that death for the sin.
속죄제 하나님 이름 너무 분명하게 예수님이 그렇게 우리 저 뭐야 어린 양이 죽어 가신 거예요.
So when you read about the sin offering, you can tell that Jesus died as a little, as a lamb for our sins.
그래서 죄를 넘겨가도록 안수를 제가 안수 저 양에게 건너갔는데.
By laying hands, your sin were transferred unto the lamb and goats.
예수님은 어떻게 하셨는가 보니까.
And when I take a look how Jesus did.
예수님은 요단과 세례를 받으면서 세례한 예수 머리 안수하시더라고.
When Jesus was baptized by John the Baptist, he received the laying of hands through John the Baptist.
보면,
and on the morrow,
요한 예수님 보고 보라 세상 죄를 지은 하나님
John saw Jesus coming toward him and said, Behold the Lamb of God which taketh away the sin of the world. So he talks about when how the sin was transferred when you do the laying of hands. So these are precisely written in the Bible. That's why when Jesus came down on this earth, in Matthew chapter
3,
Then from Galilee he came to River Jordan.
예수님께서 갈릴리에서 자라나셨죠.
So Jesus grew up in Galilee.
갈 자라나셨는데 거기서부터 이제 일을 시작하기 전인데.
So it was before he beginning his ministry.
제일 먼저 예수님은 요단강에 세례 요한의 세례를 받으러.
So he went to River Jordan to be baptized by John the Baptist.
그 이제 세례 요한의 세례를 받으러 갔는데.
So he went to be baptized by John the Baptist.
세례 요한이 세례를 베풀었어.
John the Baptist he baptized Jesus.
세례 요한 무슨 세례를 베풀었냐면.
The baptism that John the Baptist baptized gave was a baptism of repentance.
독사의 자식들.
Brood of vipers.
누가 너희를 임박한 진노를 피하라고 하느냐.
Told you to avoid the wrath that is upon you. She bore the fruit of repentance. Do not say that you are the children of Abraham. Because even God can turn the stones into the children of Abraham. So John the Baptist, he was scolding the people who came near him that they should repent. But that's when Jesus came. Jesus, he was sinless. He didn't have to repent. But why did he come for the baptism of repentance? John could not understand. Because he was the Son of God. I should rather be baptized by you, not you should come to me. And Jesus said, so thus. So for it to be so now, for thus it becometh thus fulfill all righteousness. That's when John the Baptist he baptized by laying his hands. And John the Baptist he was a son of a priest. And he was a priest as well. As he baptized him, as he did the laying of hands, the sin was transferred as was done in the sin offering. But more importantly, in John chapter 1, verse 29, on the morrow, John saw Jesus coming toward him and said, Behold, the Lamb of God which taketh away the sin of the world. So the moment Jesus was baptized, God did something amazing through him. That the sin of the world was put upon the head of Jesus. John said, I should rather be baptized by you, not you should baptize by me. Jesus said, suffer it to be so now. For thus becometh us to fulfill all righteousness. Fulfilling righteousness means in other way that the sin is washed. If the sin is washed, it will become righteous. So fulfilling righteousness means washing the sin. To have our sins washed, Jesus became the little lamb. He was crucified and died. And it depicts the scene where Jesus was died at the cross. So this story, which is written in Hebrews chapter 10, the lamb and goat bulls are taken as a sin offering in the Old Testament. These are a shadow of things to come. 속죄 제사건 예수님 십자에 못 박혀 우리 죄를 위해 죽으실 그것을 그리는 그림이에요. The sin offering is depicting and describing the Jesus who came to die for our sins. 세례요한 예수님 머리 안수하고 세상 죄가 예수님 건너갔고. So as Jesus was baptized by John the Baptist, the sin of the world was transferred to Jesus. 그 약속들을 십자에 못 박혀 죽으실 우리 죄가 사는 그 과정이 성경에 참.
정확하게 이루어져 가고 있는.
And as promised, Jesus died for our sins, and that is being accomplished in the Bible.
그래서 예수님 마지막 십자가에 못 박혀 돌아가실 때.
So when Jesus crucified at the cross and he died,
마지막에 하신 말씀이 딱 한마디 있는데.
He said one word in the end.
다 이루었다.
He said it is finished.
예, 그건 하나님의 뜻이 다 이루어진.
And it means the will of God is done. It is done. It is finished.
제가 어떤 교회 갔는데.
Once I went to a church.
주기 도문에 대해서.
And I talked about the Lord's Prayer.
예수님께 이렇게 기도하러 가지 주기 도문을 이렇게 기도하면 안 됩니까?
People they ask me, oh, Jesus taught us the prayer this way. Why can't we pray like he did?
성경을 자세히 보면 그런 뜻이 아니에요.
If you read the Bible precisely, that's not what it meant.
이 기도문을 외운다.
So you know, knowing, memorizing the you know Lord's Prayer by heart.
하나님 제일 싫어하는 거예요.
You know, this is what God hates the most.
마음에 없는 기도를 하는 거죠.
You know, that's praying without heart.
우리 아버지 이름을 거룩하게 했던 나라의 마음이 땅이 하늘에 있는 거죠.
They would pray, Our Father in which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, in the kingdom come.
이제 그게 전부 다.
You know, every one of that.
마음이 없는 이야기죠.
You know, that's heartless prayer.
마음이 없는 거 왜 사는 거야?
Those are just reciting without heart.
예수님 주기도문 가르칠 때 왜 가르치냐 아십니까?
Do you know why Jesus taught them the Lord's Prayer?
넌 기도할 때 중언 부언하지 마라.
He said you should not repeat the same repeat meaningless things over and over again. Means you should not just recite it.
자, 우리가 그 주기도문 읽다가
You know, when you read the Lord's Prayer,
오늘 우리에게 일용한 양식을 주옵시고.
He said, "You should give us the daily, give us the daily bread."
예, 양식 잔뜩 쌓아놓고 이러한 양식을 주옵시고.
Imagine you have a pile of bread at home, but if you ask for bread, that's totally meaningless, right?
그 주기는 그냥 우리 마음에 우리가 죄 지은 자 우리 죄를 사해 주옵시고.
As we forgive our neighbors, please forgive us our sins.
예, 우리가 죄 지은 자 언제 사해 줬어요?
So when have we forgiven the debts of our, you know, people debts? Forgive our sins.
뜻이 하늘 땅에서 이루어지다.
As thy will is accomplished in heaven, let your will be done on the earth.
무슨 이야기냐면,
what does that mean?
하늘 뜻이 예수님 십자가에 못 박혀 죽어 우리 죄를 사는 그게 하늘 뜻이에요.
The will of God was to wash our sin through Jesus' death on the earth.
그 뜻이 하늘에서는 이루어졌는데.
That will was accomplished in heaven.
이 땅에 내려와서 예수 십자가에 못 박혀 죽어 그 뜻이 이루어지는 거예요.
But Jesus, as he came down on this earth, he had to die to accomplish that will.
그 세례 요한에게 세례를 받으실 때.
That's why when Jesus was baptized by John the Baptist. The true meaning of the baptism it was to transfer our sins unto Jesus. Jesus did not receive the baptism of repentance because he had sins. Because that's why Jesus that's why John refused to baptize Jesus. But Jesus says, suffer it to be so now. For thus it become it us to fulfill all righteousness. So this part is amazing. Just like the sin offering in the Old Testament, they killed the lamb and goat as a sin offering.
모든 양은 예수 그리스도를 이야기하는.
You know, that lamb stands for Jesus.
예수님 우리 죄를 십자가에 못 박혀 죽어 우리 죄를 사는 그 부분을 성경은 너무 자세하게 이야기하고.
So the Bible precisely explains how Jesus died at the cross to wash our sins.
그래서 이제 우리 죄를 해서 우리가 죄를 용서해 달라고 기도해서 죄가 사해지는 게 아니고.
So it's not by our prayer that our sins are forgiven.
예수님은 당신의 몸을 제물로 바쳐서
Jesus gave his body as a sacrifice.
우리 모두의 죄를 사는 그 예식을 이루신 거예요.
He did the ritual of washing all our sins away.
저도 여러분 예수 그 피를 가지고 땅에 있는 제단에 피를 뿌리지 않았어요.
Moreover, he did not go to sprinkle his blood in the earthly tabernacle.
히브리 9장 11절이 그걸 얘기하고 있어요.
Hebrews 9 verse 11 talks about that.
우리 9장 11절을 보겠습니다.
Hebrews 9 verse 11.
그리스도께서 장래 좋은 일의 대제사장으로서 손으로 짓지 않은 곧 이 창조에 속한 더 크고 온전한 장막만.
But Christ being come and high priest of good things to come by a greater and more perfect tabernacle not made with hands that is to stay not of this building.
이 장막이란 말이 한국말로 말은 천막이란 그런 뜻이죠.
Here the word tabernacle it means tent in Korean, right?
텐트로 말미암아 만들어진 집이란 말.
So it is a house made in the form of tent.
예. 근데 이제 그들 왜 이걸 장막이라 하냐면
But why did they call it tabernacle, tent?
이스라엘에서 애굽에 나올 때 시내산에서 하나님 십계명을 주시면서
Because when the children of Israel they came out of the land of Egypt, God gave them the Ten Commandments.
성막을 만들었어요.
They were told to make the tabernacle.
장이 100규빗, 광이 50규빗.
The length 100 cubits long and the width 50 cubits long.
이동해야기 때문에
So they were supposed to, you know, move around in the wilderness.
영원한 건물을 지어 살 수가 없는데
They could not build a permanent building and live there.
성전을 천막 형태로 천막으로 성전을 지었기 때문에
That's why they built the tabernacle, the temple in the form of tent.
그걸 가지고 이제 성막이라고 말해.
So that's why they called it tabernacle, the tent.
테버네클 말이 천막이란 그런 말이었어요. 그렇죠. 영어에도 그렇다고 그러네요.
So in English is same thing, right?
그러니까 이제 그 천막이 실제 하늘나라 성소를 대신한
So the tabernacle was doing the you know the rule of the temple which is in heaven.
그래 염소와 소아지 피라 자기 피로
So not the blood of goat and lamb but with his own blood.
예수님이 그 천막에다가 성소에 천막으로 만든 성소에서 피를 흘리자.
Jesus sprinkled his blood in the temple which was made in the form of tent.
그리스도께서 장래 존일의 제사장으로서
But Christ being come and a high priest of good things to come.
히브리서 9장 11절입니다.
Hebrews 9:11.
손으로 짓지 아니한 곧 이 창조 속에 더 크고 온전한 장막으로 말.
By a greater and more perfect tabernacle not made with hands that is to say not of this building.
이 세상에 있는 교회 성전 그건 전부 다 사람의 손으로 만들었어.
The tabernacle, the churches which are on this earth, they're all built by the hands of man.
그 예수님은 사람의 손으로 만든 그 성소에 들어가서 자기 몸을 드려서 우리 속죄를 위하여 피를 흘리지 않았다.
Jesus did not shed his blood for the tabernacle which is made with the hands of man.
손 대제사 그리스도 장래 존의 대제사장으로서 손으로 짓지 아니한 곧 이 창조 속까지 더 크고 온전한 장막.
But Christ being come and high priest of good things to come by a greater and more perfect tabernacle not made with hands that is to say not of this building.
여기 장막이란 건 천막으로 된 성전을 가리켜 말.
Here the tabernacle stands for the temple which is made in the format of tents.
그 이 손으로 지진 이 창조까지 더 크고 온전한 장막이라.
So not made with hands but that is to say not of this building.
하늘나라에 있는 그 성전을 가리켜 말.
The temple it stands for the temple that is in heaven.
예수님께서 우리 죄를 그 피를 들고 땅에 있는 제단이나 성전의 피를 뿌린 게 아니라.
For our sins to be washed Jesus did not go into the tabernacle which was on the earth.
하늘나라에 있는 제단에다가 피를 뿌렸어요.
He sprinkled his blood on the altar which is in heaven.
그것도 장래 좋은 일의 대제사장으로서.
That's why it says, "But Christ being come and high priest of good things to come."
손으로 짓지 않은 곧 이 창조소까지 더 크고 온전한 장막 천막.
By a greater and more perfect tabernacle, not made with hands, that is to say, not of this building.
이 성전을 가리켜 말한데.
So it stands for this temple.
이 땅에는 모든 성전은.
All temples which are on the earth.
사람의 손으로 이어서 지어졌어.
They are built by the hands of man.
어느 성 성전이든지 간에.
No matter which temple.
근데 이 손으로 사람의 손으로 짓지 않은 곧 이 창조에 속하지 않은 더 크고 온전한 장막이란 것.
But it says by a greater and more perfect tabernacle not made with hands that is to say not of this building.
성전을 가리켜.
It means the temple which is in heaven.
예수님은 십자에 못 박힌 그 피를 가지고
Through his blood that he shed at the cross.
다른 제사장들 지금 땅에 있는 제단에 성소에 가서 제단에다 피를 뿌린 게 아니에요.
He did not sprinkle his blood just like any other priest that went into the temple which is in the earth taking with his own blood that he shed at the cross he went into the temple which is in heaven and sprinkled his blood at the altar which is in heaven this you know contains very important meaning
장막하는 장막 차이가 뭡니까?
What is the difference between the earthly and heavenly tabernacle
예, 땅은 시간계기 때문에
because this world belongs to the realm of time
땅은 과거가 있고 현재가 있고 미래가 있어
there is the past present and future on this earth
하늘나라에 있는 그 성전은 영원계기 때문에
But the temple belongs to the realm of eternity.
시간이 흐르지 않습니다.
There's no time flowing there.
거기는 과거도 없고 미래도 없습니다.
There's no past, no future.
그건 현재만 존재합니다.
There's only the present.
영원한 나라가 그런 것입니다.
That's what the eternal kingdom means all about.
이 땅에 살던 이 몸은 시간계에 필요한 몸입니다.
This body that we are wearing, it belongs to the realm of time.
늙어갑니다.
So it wears out.
내가 아직 80이 안 됐는데.
I'm less than 80 years old now.
하얗고,
My hair has turned gray. You know, I'm all old.
제가 우리 교회 앞에 큰 소나무들이 있는데.
You know, in front of our church, there are many pine trees.
소나무 사이에 낙엽성 있는 낙엽성이라고 뭐야? 낙엽이 있는데.
You know, by those, between those pine trees, I can see those maple trees.
너무 아름답게 색깔이 있어.
And they're well tinged.
그리고 교회 마당에 막 낙엽이 잔뜩 깔려 있어.
And those tinged leaves are covering the floor of our chapel.
우리 교회 그 예배당 내가 밟고 들어가니까.
So yesterday I walked through those, you know, tinged leaves.
낙엽을 받는 거 좋았는데.
And I felt like I was in the mountain, in the mountain.
오예가 그 다 썰어버렸더라고.
But in the afternoon when I came back, they all swept it.
내 썰지 마라 놔뒀는데.
I told them not to sweep it.
이때 낙엽 한번 밟으면 이제 발로.
Because this is the moment when you can step on the tinged, you know, tinged leaves.
바람 날 시원해 보이면 다 썰어버렸.
You know, they were carried away by the wind breeze. It was so good looking.
그리고 우리 그 앞에 딱 문을 열고 나오면서.
So when you come out of our chapel building.
바로 앞을 바라본 고속도 옆에. 우리 소나무 쫙 있는 소나무 앞에 낙엽으로 된 단풍이 너무너무 아름다워.
Right in front, we can see the highway. We have pine trees in front, and next to it, we have these maple trees, and they're so well tinged.
예, 어제 그 단풍을 봤는데.
I saw those tinged leaves yesterday.
어떻게 단풍이 이렇게 예쁘고 색깔이 잘 나왔나?
They couldn't be so much, you know, good, so much, you know, red, and they were so good looking.
예뻤어.
They were so pretty.
우리 교회 형제한테 갈 때 그냥 가지 말고 눈 감가지 눈 뜨고 가라.
So I told our brothers and sisters not to go back home with their eyes closed.
거기 사람은 눈이 보이면 막 그 보여요.
If they keep their eyes open, they can see that beautiful. Beautiful
우리가 있는 이 예배당, 이 성전, 뭐 이 교회, 이 몸.
So this body, this building, this chapel, this temple.
이건 시간계에 속했기 때문에.
This all belongs to the realm of time.
과거가 있고,
we have the past,
현재가 있고,
the present,
미래가 있어.
And the future.
점점 늙어 가고.
And it grows old.
그렇죠.
Right?
늙어가죠.
It grows old, right?
여러분 뭐 그런 얘기하면 안 되겠지만.
Maybe I shouldn't tell you this, but
박형규 목사 저하고는.
You know, Pastor Changgyu Park and me.
머리가 하얘져.
We all have gray hair.
이제는 제가 늙어가는 게 너무 참 그 뭐라고 말할 수 없이.
Like I don't know how to say when I see myself getting older.
어떻게 해서 주님 가까이가 더 행복하기도 한데.
I'm happy in a way because I'm getting closer to the Lord.
옛날은 머리카락이 머리 꽉 차는 머리카락이 자꾸 빠져지고 가늘어져요.
You know, before I used to have a lot of hairs, but now my hairs are getting thinner.
그래도 그냥 좀 괜찮은 편인데.
But even so, I think I'm better than anyone else.
머리카락 중간에 없는 분.
But some people they have missing hairs in the middle.
저는 제가 머리카락이 날 떠날까 봐 얼마나 다정하게 머리카락을 친했다고.
I mean, I'm dealing my hairs in a very nice way because I don't want them to leave me.
머리 자주 이렇게 깨끗하게 해주고.
So I'll keep them clean.
어떤 분들 거의 머리가 다 떠나버렸다.
You know, for some people, their hairs left them alone.
몇 분 있는데.
I saw some of them.
제가 이야기를 안 하겠습니다.
But I would mention who they are.
자 이제 이 시간계에 일어나는 이런 일들.
So these are the things that happen to the realm of time.
시간이 흘러가면서.
The time passes.
나는 늙은 표가 아무리 옛날 제가 스물 뭐 네 살 다섯 살 때는.
When I was only 24, 25 years old before.
제가 너무 나이가 어린 것 같아서.
Because I thought that I was too old to be a minister, too young to be a minister. So I wanted to look older.
날 보고 몇 살이냐 물어보고.
So people, when people ask me how old are you?
몇 살 같이 보이느냐.
How old do I look? I would ask them first.
대답해 주기 싫어서.
Because I didn't want to answer them.
근데 그거하고 이제 지금 완전히 달라가지고.
But now I'm in the totally different situation.
말하던 늙어 보이잖아.
Because now I look old now, right?
늙었다.
And I'll tell them, yes, I'm old. I'm just living like that.
이제 너 나이가 많아져 머리가 휘어져 이렇게 보면서.
As I'm getting older, my hairs are turning gray.
한 번씩 생각해 봐.
I'll think about it once in a while.
앞으로 내가 몇 년 더 살 수 있어?
How many years do I have left?
그 생각해 보면은.
So when I think about that.
약간 행복한 마음도 있고.
And I'm happy in a way.
또 이제 가족들 있는 아이들은 못 보고 간단히 좀 서슴하기도 하고.
But when I think about my family, I feel a little disappointed.
근데 이제 우리에게 좋은 게 뭐냐면.
But the one good thing for us.
하나님이 저에게 이런 세상 이제 늙어가는 이게 인생이 다가 아니다.
Is that this life is not the end?
끝이 아니고 새로운 영원히 사는 세계가 약속돼 있다.
This life is not the end, but we have the world where we live eternally.
누구만 들을 수 있느냐면.
Who can get into that eternal world?
받은 사람만 들어갈 수.
Those who have received the forgiveness of sin, they can get into the world of eternity.
우리가 어떤 노력 수월을 제가 사야지는 게 아니라.
So we don't have to do anything for that eternity.
제 구약에 어떻게 제가 너만 그걸 자세히 설명해서 속죄 제사란 걸 만든.
In the Old Testament, it explains precisely how our sins are washed. That's the sin offering.
여호와의 금년 부중에 하나를 보면 그 범한 죄 허물이 있다.
If any of the common people sin against the commandment of the Lord and found guilty in His sight,
그 범한 죄의 깨우침을 받고,
and come to have the knowledge of his sins that he committed,
이제 죄의 삭은 사망이니까,
the wages of sin is death.
죄를 대신 죽을 암염소를 자고,
so he needs a female goat that has to die in his place.
그것을 예물로 삼아서,
and they have to take it as an offering.
속죄제 머리에 안수하고,
and they have to lay their hands on the head of it.
자, 이 양이나 염소는 내 죄를 대신 죽으려고 예비된 양이에요.
This lamb or goat, they're prepared to die in our place.
그래서 그 염소의 머리 안수를 통해서
So through laying our hands on the head of the goat or lamb,
모든 죄를 그 양이나 염소께 넘겨버려.
We then transfer our sin onto the lamb or goat.
제가 그걸 안수하는 걸 몰라가지고
I did not know what it meant before.
한 얼마 동안 고민을 했어요.
So for a while, I thought about it.
왜 양이나 염소를 안수해야 하는
거야? Why do we have to do the laying of hands?
목사 되는 것도
We're not ordaining it as a pastor.
안수를 받아야 되지.
We're not ordaining as an elder. Why do you have to do the laying of hands?
정말 저는 그걸 잘 몰라.
I was truly curious to know why.
성경을 읽으면서
But as I read the Bible,
그것이 바로 저 뭐야 마태복음 3장에서
In Matthew chapter 3,
세례 요한이 예수의 세례를 베푸는 거예요.
John the Baptist, he baptized Jesus.
예수의 세례를 받으러 오니까
When Jesus came to be baptized,
요한이 다른 사람들에게 세례를 줬는데
John, he baptized other people.
예수님이 하나님 아들인 거라고 주저했어요.
But knowing that he was the son of God, he hesitated.
세례를 받아 당신이 내게
오시나이 I should rather be baptized by you. Why do you want to be baptized by me? Then Jesus is afraid to be so now.
우리가 이와 같이 모든 의를 이루는 것이
For thus becometh thus fulfill all righteousness.
아, 그러니까 이제 그 양이나 염소 안수해서 죄가 양이나 염소 건너가고 난 뒤에 그 양이 죄를 떼도 죽음으로 죄가 사해지는데.
By laying hands, when the sin is transferred, we kill the lamb or goat to have our sins washed.
이제 그 양은 예수 그때 그림자고.
So that lamb stands for Jesus.
진짜 양이 되신 예수님이 땅에 오셨는데.
And Jesus came on the earth as a lamb of God.
제자들이 양의 머리 안수하면 죄가 양이 건너가듯이.
So when the priest do the laying of hands, the sin would be transferred.
예수님 우리 죄를 못 넘겨받기 위해서.
Just like that, in order to take the charge of our sins.
세례요한이 가서 안수를 받기.
He went before John to be baptized. He wanted to be baptized by John. It was not the baptism of repentance that he took before John. But through that laying of hands, the sin was transferred unto Jesus. So John the Baptist baptized Jesus. And that's how he was baptized by John the Baptist. That's when the sin of the whole humanity was transferred unto Jesus. The heaven opened and they heard the voice of God. This is the son, my son whom, in whom I'm pleased.
왜?
And my beloved son, why? Because Jesus, in order to die for our sins,
과정, 그
through the sin, through the baptism, he took over our sins.
요한이서, 자, 요한복음 1장 29절을 보면,
and in John chapter 1, verse 29,
이튿날 예수께서, 요한이 예수께서 자기 나오시면 보았는데,
on the morrow, when John saw Jesus coming toward him,
보라,
he said,
세상 죄를 지은 하나님의 어린 양이로.
Behold, the Lamb of God which taketh away the sin of the world.
이제 그 죄가 예수님께 건너갔는데.
So that sin was transferred unto Jesus.
그 제가 예수님 건너간 예수 어린 양 그걸 나타내기 위하여.
So in order to manifest that as a little Lamb of God,
속죄 제사라는 게 있어서.
There is a sin offering in the Old Testament.
양을 잡아가 제사를 드리기 전에 양의 머리 안수에 죄를 넘기고 양을 잡아 제사 드리면 죄가 사해지는 그걸 얘기.
Before killing the lamb, they do the laying of hands to transfer their sins, and then they killed it to have their sins washed.
이제 그게 구약 예언으로 되어 왔다가 실제로 이루어지는 것은
It was prophesied in the Old Testament. It was later done.
예수님을 팔고
And as a Judas Iscariot betrayed Jesus,
죽으시면서
Jesus was crucified at the cross.
그때 우리의 모든 죄가 넘어갔고 그 죄의 값을 받으셨기
When he shed his blood, that's when the wages of our sins were paid through his blood.
그때 우리의 모든 죄가 다 사해지고
That's when all our sins were washed.
성경을 생각하면 그런 게 너무 정확하게 딱딱해요.
So upon meditating the Bible, this is so precisely written.
예수님 안수 받은 그때부터 예수님은 세상 죄를 지고 하셨.
From the moment he was baptized, he was carrying the sin of the world.
죄를
the Baptist said, "Behold the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world."
십자가에 못 박혀 죽으심으로.
Carrying our sins, he died at the cross.
우리의 모든 죄가 눈처럼 희게시는 이 사실을 믿는 것입니다.
And he washed our sins as white as snow. This is what we believe.
오늘 찬송은 부르고 하지만
Many people today they sing the hymns.
실제로 우리 죄가 사해진 것을 믿지 못 주여 죄인이라고 하는 사람들이 너무 많습니다.
But in reality, people they don't come to believe that their sins are washed. That's why they say that they are sinners.
목회자들이 잘못한.
And I think this is the work of many pastors. The pastors they should teach the Bible in the correct way. The Christianity today has become just a religion. They just think about doing the good work. They don't talk about the sin offering. Because people they don't know. There are many people suffering in sin without about knowing how their sins are washed.
구약 양을 잡아 제사 드린 이 제사는
the sin offering that people they gave in the Old Testament.
양을 잡아 제사 드는 게 아니라
this was not a simple ritual where they gave a lamb or goat.
사는 것처럼
but through the like the death of the lamb.
예수님 십자가에 못 박고 우리 죄를 사는 그것을 가르치기 위한 목적이 바로 그 속죄 제사.
Through the lamb our sins were washed just like that. Through Jesus our sins were washed.
근데 이제는 왜 제사를 안 드리냐?
So now why don't we give the sin offering anymore? We don't need it anymore now.
그래서
He died at the cross, and He washed our sins eternally. Therefore, the sin offering ended there. And taking that blood, He did not go into the earthly tabernacle, but He sprinkled the blood on the earth, which is in heaven. And this world belongs to the realm of time. But the sin offering that He gave in the kingdom of God, the offering was eternal there.
사람들이 그 이야기를 잘 못 믿습니다.
Many people they cannot hardly believe this.
그래서 오늘 자기 생각을 따르면 자기 죄를 지었는데.
That's why according to their thought they sinned.
예수님 죽은 것 사실은 또 죄를 지은 죄인이다.
Although Jesus died for their sins, but they still think that they are sinners.
그래서 예수님은 그 피를 땅에 있는 제단에 뿌린 게 하늘나라 제단에 뿌림으로.
That is why Jesus did not sprinkle his blood on the altar which is on the earth, but in the heaven.
영원한 속죄를 이루셨어.
And he accomplished eternal redemption.
자 로마서 히브리 9장 11절.
Let's go back to Hebrews 9 verse 11.
그리스도께 장래 좋은 일의 대제사장으로 오사.
But Christ being come and high priest of good things to come.
성소가 더 크고 온전한 장막으로 말미암아.
By a greater and more perfect tabernacle not made with hands, that is to say, not of this building.
12절에,
verse 12.
염소와 송아지 피라냐.
Not neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood.
영원한 속죄를 이루사 단번에 성소에 들어가.
He entered in once into the holy place, having obtained eternal redemption for us.
죽으심으로 말미암아.
So as he died at the cross,
우리가 영원히 씻어졌어.
Our sins were washed eternally.
영원한 속죄를 이루사.
He accomplished eternal redemption. This is what we believe.
예수님 죽으러 내가 뭐 거짓말한지 도둑질한지 뭐 간음한지 또 다음에 뭐 낙태한지 그런 죄를 산 것이 아니야.
Jesus did not only washed our lyings and stealing and you know theft and abortion, but he accomplished eternal redemption.
그 구약에 양을 잡고 소를 잡아 드린 그 제사는.
You know those offering of killing calf and goats in the Old Testament.
예수님 우리 죄를 살 그 모형이요 그림자지.
It is a model and shadow of Jesus dying at the cross. It is not the very image. And by Jesus' death at the cross, the sin was done, washed eternally. Our sins were all washed. There is no more work. There is no more work left to do for us, but when we have faith in it, then we can live true spiritual life. Since 1962, I began to preach this gospel. God bestowed His grace upon me until recently through our books, through many broadcastings. You could preach this gospel. And you could see this wonderful work. Many people got saved. When I think about that, I'm so thankful I cannot describe that in words. And I'm so grateful before God.
하나님께서 우리 속에 계속 보호의 문을 여신 너무 감사합니다.
When I see God opening the gate for us for the gospel, we are so thankful.
우리가 이번에 이 말씀이 정말 영원한 속죄에 대해 정확히 아셔서.
Everyone, I hope you'd come to discover this world concerning the eternal redemption, so that no one would be bound by sin.
실제 구약 양을 잡아 드는 그 제사는
the sin offering
그걸 예표로 보여주는 것입니다.
The sin offering which was given in the Old Testament is a model of Jesus dying at the cross in the New Testament.
그 말씀 그대로 예수님이 오셔 십자에 못 박혀 죽으심으로.
So that it was as it was written, Jesus died at the cross.
우리가 영원히 사해졌다고 믿습니다.
And our sins are washed eternally. This is what we believe.
그런데 아직도 자기 생각에서 벗어나질 못해서.
But there are many people who are still bound by their sins and their thoughts. And they think that they are sinners.
예수 피로 우리 죄가 사해졌는데.
But even so, our sins are washed through Jesus.
사해졌다면 그걸 믿지 못한 분들이 많습니다.
But there are many people who do not come to believe.
This.
But through the book of Hebrews, how our sins are washed, I can teach you precisely that all those who are still bound by the sin, I hope that they would receive this grace of forgiveness of sin and receive and praise the Lord together. Again, thank you. We'll pray.
사랑하는 거룩하신 하나님 아버지,
Heavenly Father, we thank you.
우리 더러운 죄에서 구원하기 위하여,
in order to save us from our dirty sins.
십자가에 예수의 사랑이 너무 큽니다.
Your love at the cross was so great.
예수님 우리의 눈처럼 이게 씻어 놨는데,
you washed our sins as white as snow.
이걸 믿지 않고 그냥 멸망한 주님 얼마나 가슴 아파하겠습니까?
There are many people are dying without believing this. How much that will break your heart, Lord? Let us preach this gospel around the world.
우리 성경만 또 좀 더 자세히 알고,
as we learn this Bible more precisely this time, let us preach the true gospel so that many people would be saved. Let us discover the value of your blood, Lord. We thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we prayed.
Amen.
Thank you, everyone.